Hi Capricorn, welcome to Omkara Tarot, and let's do an energy check-in for you for the mid-month of August. So Capricorn, these are general collective readings, will not resonate with each and every one of you, okay? So take what works for you, leave the rest. So these, Capricorn, are you and yours readings. So this is you and the person who's affecting your energy the most at this time. So this could be a love interest, could be your neighbor, could be your boss, could be a relative, parent, anyone, right? So let's see who wants to come out for you today. And of course, your love readings were just put up. If you want to check those out, I'll leave a link at the end of this video. With that said, let's begin. Dear God, goddesses, angels, spirit guides, please bless this reading for Capricorn and send them the messages they need to hear the most at this time. Thank you. So Capricorn, let's begin. Thank you all my subscribers for all your love, your comments, shares, likes. I thank you. And if you're new here, we're a small Omkara family. Do subscribe, join our channel. We meet here weekly for all kinds of readings, love, you and yours, monthlies, bi-monthlies. We welcome you in. And let me explain this to you. I'm setting down two sets of cards, one for you, one for your person. And in the center, I will be having your mutual energies here. So, let's see. Let's start with side A. I'll be referring to these two sides as person A and person B. You decide which side you resonate best with, okay? So, person A has the Ace of Swords, the Lovers, the Empress, Ace of Pentacles, Seven of Wands, and the Page of Wands. Person B has the Tower, Ace of Cups, Five of Wands, Queen of Swords, Judgment, and the Hierophant. Wow. Okay, so let's start with person A, Capricorn. Capricorn, person A has the Ace of Swords, but it's in reverse. So there's still not very clear, there's not much clarity regarding, I think, this love situation. This definitely is a love reading, Capricorn. I think that's uppermost on your mind right now. And it's showing through as not much clarity on this love situation. There may be a bit of silence between the two of you. You may be kind of making a decision right now as to what to do. Right now you're really not sharing, not giving. You don't know what to do. You've kind of pulled back. And I think this is a choice being made. Yeah, you've pulled your love back right now. There is a lot of love here. There is a lot of love here, but I think maybe you're trying to use your intuition right now to see what choice should I make, right? Should I kind of move forward with this person or not? You're not very clear. You're not very clear, even though the love is there, yeah. But the Empress is right now in reverse. That means you're really not taking any action to show them or having any growth with this person. Yeah, maybe going through a lot of stress and anxiety and tension regarding this, wish fulfillment that will this work out, won't it? Is this the person that I'm supposed to be with? What choice should I make? Right now, things are a bit hazy and you're not really clear. But you are headed for a, Ace of Pentacles, which is brand new beginnings. You want it. Yeah. I think maybe in the past somebody walked away. Somebody walked away from this connection, and that is what kind of put you in this flux of is it going to happen, won't it happen. But from what I see, from person A side, either you are wanting now to take an apology, or you're going to receive an apology or a love offer. I have two cards which dropped out together, right? Ace of Cups and Knight of Cups. So these are both cards representing that, yes, somebody, I think, kind of withdrew from this connection with the Seven of Wands, kind of became a bit guarded and defensive and said, hey, I don't want to work on this, or I don't want to, I don't know, I don't want to move on this, I don't want to have a fresh new beginning, but yet heart of hearts stressed out. So since there was no communication from person A to person B, now there is some kind of you know, action being taken to kind of bring this back into balance. Somebody's coming with an apology or a love offer very soon. Yes, a tower moment. A tower moment. Can you imagine, Capricorn? I have a tower moment for both of you. Person A and person B going through a huge tower moment. Now, what is this tower moment is what I need to know. It's going to be the good one because I see people coming out of their, you know, feeling abandoned and feeling lost and feeling hurt and whatever, you know, this lack of love in their life. So let's see, Spirit, what is this tower moment for person A? Let's take them separately. I have two towers here to deal with right now. So what's the tower moment for person A? What's happening, Spirit? Okay. One more, Spirit. What's the tower moment? I think somebody's coming back to person A with an apology, with a sorry, saying that I want to have a stable new beginning with you and I want to be victorious with you. And this is going to be a shocker. Yeah, they want to marry you. Oh God, wow. Look at this. So this is going to be the shock. After no communication, there's been no communication, right? Till now, you've been worried, person A has been worried, it's not going to work out, not going to work out. And suddenly, out of the blue, here comes the proposal. This person wants to win you over, is coming with a stable offer to you, coming with, you know, romance, love, flirtation, apology, everything. Wow. Let's see person 2's tower now. What's happening with you, person B? Why are you in a tower moment here? Yeah, they felt the rejection. They felt the rejection from person A. They felt that, oh my God, see, this is what person A was doing. They kind of backed off and said, hey, I'm not sure, I don't want you, and go away, I'm still making my choice. And they didn't maybe expect it. And this was their tower moment to say, oh, really? I mean, like, you're not going to accept me where I have so much love for you. So person B really, really has a lot of love for person A. And to get rejected was like a big tower moment. They want to reconcile with you immediately. They want you back, person A, whoever you are. I don't know whether you're this side or the other side. But person B has a lot of love. They want to reconcile. They are feeling the tower moment of you pushing them back and not accepting that them. Spirit, can I have a card, please, for the Ace of Cups? Yes, they see person A as this passionate, beautiful, oh my God, this is their wish fulfillment. The woman who lights up the room whenever she walks into the room. Their heart, eyes all light up, and not only theirs, they see people around them eyeing, you know, this person to say, oh my God, and they can't believe that this person A can become theirs, right? So they have a lot of love for person A, and they are not happy that person A is thinking about it and may or may not be with them. So this became their tower moment. Now they want to end all conflict, okay? They don't want to have any conflict, and let's see, Five of Wands, Spirit. Five of Wands. They want to offer you marriage. They want to have a commitment with you. Oh my God, I mean, this is like... I mean, they have the Hierophant twice on their end. They really want you. They really want you big time, and they don't want an affair with you or anything like that. They want a long-term committed relationship. The Four of Wands, the Hierophant. And they don't want to fight anymore with person A anymore. They want it to be, yeah, they want to communicate this to you. They want to talk to you. They want to have clear communication with you. And let's see this Queen of Swords on their end. Yeah. They are feeling this Queen of Swords, that I think is the feminine energy, has left them out in the cold. You know, they're feeling abandoned. They're feeling sad. They're feeling miserable. If they want to have a restart, they want to have a rebirth of this connection, and they want it like this, like the Hierophant. Okay? They really want a committed... they don't like the fact that the feminine energy has kind of put her sword up and said, hey, I'll think about it or whatever. So they're saying, oh my God, what? I can't. Yeah, see, need I say more? I mean, they are so passionately attached to you. The masculine here is totally attached to the feminine and they can't get them off their mind. And they are not going to take no for an answer, that's for sure. So, spirit judgment. Yes, they want a brand new cycle with you. They want to finish whatever happened in the past. They don't want to even, be bothered with the way things went. And they want a re-beginning, restart with the judgment card and the world card. And they want it this way, the committed way. Very nice. Now, I don't know whether this is the feminine Capricorn or this is you, but yes, one person, you'll know your place, right? So one person is thinking about it. I'll think about it. I'm not too sure. I may or may not give you my love. And this one is going ballistic to say, oh my God. So Hierophant spirit. Yes, this person is in a self-imposed prison right now. They are so stressed. They're so stressed. They don't know what to do, whether you'll accept them back or not. Okay, they are wanting you desperately. Okay, so let's see. They want to come out of this place. They want to come out of feeling left out, abandoned, sad, and they are feeling miserable that you're not kind of giving to this connection, or person A is not giving to this connection. So let's see your mutual energy here, Capricorn. Strength in reverse. Five of Cups in reverse. Very nice. And Justice. Wonderful. So, I think both of you are going to put your resistance down. Okay, first of all. I think if all these barriers that have been put up, mostly by person A, yes, I think you're both going to say, okay, let's give it one more shot. Okay, let's fight for this connection. No more kind of putting barriers up and warding the other person off. Yeah, this is a soulmate connection, Capricorn. This is somebody who you've had sweet memories with for a long time, maybe a decade or more, or maybe lifetimes, okay? This is maybe your best friend who's fallen in love with you or something like that. This is your soulmate, yes. This is a very powerful connection. And I think now coming up, you're going to be putting down your resistance to this. Yes, if you've been holding back or, not this thing. Now I think the feminine is going to start nurturing this connection once again. Okay? There will be growth. There will be growth. Till now, I think one person's being a little stubborn and holding back. But I think that's soon going to come to an end with the Five of Cups, right? Five of Cups in reverse. So the Five of Cups upright would be, you're regretting the past and something's not happened. But it's in reverse, which means, yes, now you both are no longer thinking about what didn't happen or what could have happened. You are looking back to see those two beautiful full cups which are behind you. See? You've decided to turn around and pick up these two cups, which is really nice. So let's see, Five of Cups spirit. I think you both realize that, thinking about what can't happen or what didn't happen or what is not possible has only put you both into a loveless situation, right? You both are kind of now wanting to see what's ahead for new ships to come in, new horizons to explore together. Because without each other, I don't think you feel very happy. There's no love in the world, I think, without each other. And all you want is to have wish fulfillment and be very happy. So I think you're both going to give it another shot. To say, okay, let's give this a shot. Let's see what the future has, for us now. And yes, in the end, I do have the Justice card. Okay, things will be put back into balance, I think, very soon. So, Spirit, Justice card, please. One more. One more card, Spirit. I like to take a lot of clarifiers for the end so that, I can give you a very, very clear message. Okay, so somebody's coming in A very fast. Okay, they're coming to you. They want to have a passionate new beginning with you, okay? If things have not been put right or the things are not good in the end, I mean, previously, if there is anyone feeling like, oh, I don't want love and I'm not accepting, this cup is going to be offered to you. A lot of thinking has happened, it's over, it's done, but now with this new message that you're going to get of, you know, it's going to be passion filled, it's going to be about forward movement, okay, which may just kind of put the scales back, and it's going to be a very nice, I think, union here. This is going to happen quickly. So, anything else, Spirit? Yeah. If there's been any conflict or any fighting, Capricorn, there's a death to the old and a big transformation is about to happen in your life. It's out with the old, in with the new now. Okay? This could be with the same relationship. Don't think I'm saying new lover or anything like that. Whatever hasn't grown in the path is past is now has a potential. So, of course, you all have free will. This is coming, right? End to the old ways of doing things is definitely coming. Justice is coming. So, if you feel that, you know, this is your person, give it a shot because they do love you a lot. And if you feel, no, I'm overdone, I don't think so. I don't think so. Your person A also is just hiding their feelings. A big transformation is definitely possible here in a very good way. So, let's see an angel blessing card. I don't see any toxicity in any place. So, let's take an angel blessing card. Spirit, can we have one please for my Capricorns? Oh, not so many, Spirit. Just one at a time, please. Thank you. This is going to be a blessed union if you go for it, Capricorn. I really don't see anything wrong with it. Spirit says be optimistic. Look forward. If you've been like, you know, thinking, oh, is this the right person? Is this not the right person? A, definitely it seems to be a soulmate, right? I have the higher education, which is spiritual learning card here. This is a soulmate, yeah? So just be optimistic that yes, this thing can work. Bring some sweetness back into this relationship. Okay, try and bring some happiness, sweetness back into this union. And once you do that, because this is a soulmate connection, many, many, many blessings of abundance are going to come into your life. Now, Capricorn, abundance doesn't just mean money. Abundance is of love, it's of health, it's of emotional satisfaction, physical satisfaction, creative, all kinds. So, Spirit says once this union comes about, and you are optimistic about your love life, bring some happiness and sweetness, you will be blessed. So I think this is a very, you will feel, you know, you've come out of the cold finally when you are with this person. So that's all I have for you, Capricorn. Till next week then, love and light, take care, namaste, and do hit a like once in a while. Makes me feel good. Thank you.